Yuko Tojo, May 20, 1939, Keijo, Japanese Korea, February 13, 2013, Tokyo, Japan, was a Japanese ultra-nationalist politician, Imperial Japanese apologist, and brief political hopeful when she was the granddaughter of General Hideki Tōjō, the Japanese wartime prime minister who was convicted of planning and orchestrating most of the major Japanese acts of aggression of World War II. For these crimes, Hideki Tōjō was convicted as a Class A war criminal and hanged after World War II. 1. Politics. In May 2007, Tōjō revealed her intention to run in the House of Councillors election at the age of 68. She ran on a far-right platform, demanding the enshrinement of all of Japan's military war dead, to include Class A war criminals such as her grandfather. At the controversial Yasukuni Shrine II, Tōjō also adopted a policy of blanket denialism of any Japanese war crimes during World War II, which she angrily dismissed as purely U.S. propaganda, designed to smear the glorious reputation of the proud and honorable Japanese warrior race. She vowed to work to throw out the Japanese Constitution if elected, which bans all offensive warfare in perpetuity, with Tōjō dismissing the non-offensive clause as racist, obstructionist, and created entirely by the hand of American manipulators and intended to keep the Japanese people in a slave state to Western interests. Tōjō was also a particularly strong patron of the truth about Nanjing, a fringe propaganda movie in production by Japanese ultranationalist revisionist filmmaker Satoru Mizushima, who claims that the 1937 Nanking massacre was completely fabricated by the United States and China in a collaborative effort to slander the glorious exploits of the Japanese soldier in World War II, which Mizushima and Tōjō view as the highest point of Japanese civilization. According to Mizushima and Tōjō, there were no murders or rapes ever committed in Nanking except for a few, which were committed by U.S./Chinese spies in order to create false photographs to slander the honor of the Imperial Japanese Army. 3. Tōjō was subsequently mocked and accused of racism, conspiracy theorism, and radical, antiquated ultra-conservatism by her own countrymen for her statements. Many left-of-center and centrist politicians objected strongly to her term warrior race, a heavily loaded racial term which has not been used since the heyday of Imperial Japan in the 1940s. "There are no war criminals in Japan," Tōjō famously announced, a statement which prompted derision and mockery from the Japanese political left and embarrassment from the Japanese political right, many of whom are sympathetic to the shrine burial issue but embarrassed by the extreme nature of Tōjō's other demands, such as the scrapping of the Japanese constitution. A commentator noted that now even the far right seem hesitant to back her. Other infamous comments by Tōjō include the war was started by the meddling of the Western gangster thugs and no Japanese warrior ever committed a crime if his heart's true intent was the expansion of our grand empire. Tōjō also frequently lionized her grandfather in speeches, calling Hideki Tōjō a true and honorable son of Japan, who died clean and innocent at the hands of a combined United States/Chinese conspiracy. She even managed to alienate her former supporters on the right, including Prime Minister Shinzo Abe, who, despite agreeing that Japan's World War II war criminals should be reburied among the regular soldiers, pointedly distanced himself from the remainder of Tōjō's harsh racial rhetoric, especially her demands for a new constitution that would permit Japan to wage offensive war again, a concept Abe called madness. Tōjō's strong nationalistic attitude might appeal to certain extreme elements of the population, but most Japanese do not sympathize with her views. "She has no chance at all at the elections," stated one commentator. Death. Tōjō died on February 13, 2013 at the age of 74, 10 years after her entry into politics, still a firm believer in Japanese racial exceptionalism, racial purity, and complete innocence of any war crimes in World War II. Quotes. "Japan did not fight a war of aggression. It fought in self-defense. Our children have been wrongly taught that their ancestors did evil things, that their country is evil. We need to give these children back their pride and confidence. 2. In Japan, there are no war criminals. Every one of those enshrined at Yasukuni died fighting for their country, and we should honor them. 2. Many people, including Kayama, believe that the atomic bomb stopped Japan's aggression, but Japan did not fight a war of aggression, said Tojo, who claimed the war was fought to liberate the non-white colonies in Asia from the whites. If there was one mistake, however, it was the fact that we lost. And if my grandfather is to blame, it's not because he started the war but because we lost. Quoted in an article by the Japan Times, written by Setsuko Kamiya on July 11, 2007, citation needed. People think I'm a hawk, but I'm actually a dove on the torii of Yasukuni Shrine. Quoted in an article by the Japan Times, written by Setsuko Kamiya on July 11, 2007, citation needed.
Please subscribe and thanks for watching.